So fibrosis is a tissue injury response. It occurs in many organs. It can be a replacement fibrosis if cells have died, but fibrosis can also become a very essential part of the disease process, and we currently have no therapies to revert this fibrotic process. That's why this microRNA-21 inhibition is a potential very promising target. So the original finding for microRNA-21 was in the heart and on cardiac fibrosis, but the same findings have been recapitulated in many other organ systems. And we were asking the question, what is the mechanism of action? How microRNA-21 inhibition actually ameliorates fibrosis. This work was done by a clinical PhD student in my group, Dr. Timo Bavari, and we started off by looking at the effects of this microRNA on the most logical cell type, which is the fibroblast. However, to our great surprise, manipulating this microRNA in fibroblasts didn't induce any notable effects on the secretion of these matrix proteins which form fibrosis. So we really had to look for an alternative explanation, and that's why we leveraged proteomics data on a population-based study where we correlated microRNA-21 levels in the circulation against plasma proteomics data. And we found a surprising match between microRNA-21 and many platelet-derived proteins, including the well-known profibrotic factor, transforming growth factor beta-1. So we then went back to the experimental models and could show that indeed in the bone marrow, TGF-beta-1 is mainly produced by megakaryocytes. It's carried from the bone marrow into the circulation. And in fact, our plasma levels of this profibrotic factor are largely determined by the release from platelets. And that then posed the obvious question, how microRNA-21 may affect megakaryocytes rather than fibroblasts. And what we could show, again using proteomics, that this microRNA regulates the release of alpha granular proteins, including TGF-beta, from platelets. So I think it actually provides a new explanation how this inhibition of this microRNA could be antifibrotic, not necessarily by locally affecting the fibroblasts, but actually by having systemic effects on the bone marrow and one target cell being the megakaryocyte and the platelet. I think this is a very exciting time because we have novel microRNA therapeutics, you know, getting into the clinic. But the key question is, of course, safety and delivery mechanisms, and it's local versus systemic delivery. And in many cases, local delivery is preferable because you may minimize side effects. On the other hand, if you actually have a systemic effect that results in the treatment outcome, local delivery may not be a feasible option. So I think it is very important to really assess the microRNA effects at a systems-wide level rather than just pretty much focus on one cell type of interest, because it may be the wrong target cell you're looking at if you don't actually open your view on other cell types. There's already some publications looking at microRNA-21 in monocytes and inflammatory cells, where it is one of the most abundant microRNAs in monocytes and macrophages. We have now looked at megakaryocytes. But again, the bottom line is that this inhibition of the microRNA is a very potent way of inhibiting fibrosis. So if we can figure out how it actually does that, there may be other avenues of therapies which may be clinically more applicable than inhibiting the microRNA, how we could actually treat fibrosis, which is a common problem in many diseases, not just in cardiovascular disease, the area I'm working in. For this collaboration, the financial support of the Foundation Leduc was really instrumental. The Foundation Leduc funded a transatlantic network of excellence on vascular microRNAs, and this enabled us to actually have these interactions and the access to the different mouse models and samples, because our expertise is mainly on the proteomic side, and of course within these networks we can get access to expertise that we don't necessarily have in our own group. And my own funding comes from the British Heart Foundation, and I'm a British Heart Foundation chair of cardiovascular proteomics.